Hello everyone, welcome to our channel IAC Steno. We are starting the passage at speed of 100 word per minute. Start. Administration, as we all know, has grown not only in volume but also in complexity. So it is but proper that the House attaches the greatest importance to the machinery which is charged with the responsibility of seeing that the recruitment and the discipline of the services are maintained at the highest possible standard. Sir, the report before the House gives a clean bill to the government, but from what some of the honorable members pointed out during the debate, it seems to me that the report is significant for what it omits to say. For instance, my honorable friend Mr. Bhargava drew attention to a number of alleged irregularities on the part of the commission and the ministries. We do not know how far they are true because they do not find a place in the report. Probably they fall outside the ears to which the report relates. But if the observations made by my honorable friend are borne out by facts, it is a matter for serious consideration. If the commission's role should be what it is generally expected to be by the government and the House, it has probably to assume a superior role if it is to control effectively the policy of recruitment and the standard of efficiency in the services generally. Sir, I shall not go into the question referred to by the honorable member, and we expect the honorable member to throw more light on the aspects which were brought to the notice of the House. Sir, reference has been made to a fall in standards. It is said that education in the universities and the educational system generally should improve, and unless that is so, we cannot have the desired personnel to man the services. In that connection, honorable members have referred to the need for improving not only the university stage of education but also the secondary stage. I would like to go a step further and say that the whole system of education has to be looked upon as one integrated whole, and unless we strengthen our educational system from the very bottom, it is no use our concentrating only on the university stage or the secondary stage. Even from the primary level, education as a whole is in a melting pot, not with regard to the curriculum alone, but also with regard to the medium of education and its objectives. Sir, I would now refer to the question of examinations. Much has been said on whether there should be an oral test and what its place should be in deciding the merits of applicants. Sir, I feel compelled to say that the Viva Voice test is very necessary to select proper persons for the services. There is nothing sacrosanct about the written test. It depends, it is true, on the intellectual discipline that a person has gone through, but that is not all for judging the merit of a person. The personality of an individual is many-sided. Just as people have said that it is difficult to judge the worth of a person in a 15-minute interview, I submit that it is equally difficult to judge the capacity or the efficiency of a person by the amount of crammed knowledge that he is able to put out. We know that the government itself is not satisfied with the system of education and it is thinking of reforming it. So, sir, there can be no final word about it, but the system of selection has to be determined as much as possible after taking into account all the factors that go to make a personality today. Then, sir, I would like to say a word about the constitution of the commission itself. Much has been said about the need to maintain the dignity of the commission and the preeminent place given to it in the constitution. We are all agreed on that. It is necessary, I feel, that non-official members of the commission should be given security in their later years by providing for pension. But I would like to know how many non-official members are in the UPSC. I think the strength of the non-official element is very little, and I would in this connection point out to the government the need for taking in more men from public life. Sir, at the present moment, it is dominated by the official element. It is true that there are distinguished men from the educational and other fields, but then we have to have regard to the needs of the present day administration when we have passed from the regulatory stage of the government to the welfare stage, and to have persons in our services who have a broader outlook on our problems. I would in this connection recall the observations of Dr. Appleby when he said, with regard to the Indian Administrative Service, that a member of that service was more conscious of his membership of the service to which he belonged. Stop.